start to regret things. You only get one life, and every time you look into yours, you feel like everything you have is a waste. And the problem and the reason you can never fill a hole in your life is because you were never awake.
You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape, 'cause you live.
Okay, we here with another NF video. Are you excited? Because I am. The title of this one is Wake Up. This is my first time listening to this. I didn't even check it out. I'm like, okay, it's time for another NF. I'm reading my comments and I'm like, okay, wake up. All right, you're up next. Yeah, let's do it. Thank you so much for listening. Once again, my name is Pastor James Devalon. I'm glad you clicked this video. There are millions of videos on YouTube. You could have watched any other channel, but you came to mine. I appreciate that. Again, God bless you for taking the time to check us out here in the Look and Live YouTube channel. All right, if you happen to be new, make sure you like and subscribe, okay? So if you're one of those returning viewers, we just want to thank you so much just for all the support and the love that you share with us here in this channel. I want to say special thanks to the members of the Look and Live YouTube channel. There are a few of you who are standing with us on a monthly basis, and you're going beyond your means to do that. Believe me, I know. I read your emails. I get the message. Appreciate you for doing that. Part of the reasons why we can do what we're doing here is because you're partnering with us, and I appreciate that very much. Let us go into NF right now. I hope you are ready. So this is NF Wake Up. Without further ado, let us now get into the heart of the message.
You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape, 'cause you live your life in a coma you never awake. If you'd open your eyes, then maybe you'd see what's at stake. You're sleeping.
You make a lot of money and you live in a mansion and pretty much got everything that you could ever imagine. But you feel like even though you got everything in the world, you got nothing. So what you do then is you start going backwards. You run in a direction and you looking for something that isn't real. And all you know is that you just gotta have it. What you're doing is sleeping and thinking that you're awakening out. And the problem is that you don't know what you're after. So you put everything that you have into what you do, hoping that one day maybe you don't have to feel like you're empty. But as you get older, a lot of weight in your shoulders is getting heavy. Then you look back and you start to regret things. You only get one life, and every time you look into your, you feel like everything you have is a waste. And the problem and the reason you can never fill a hole in your life is because you were never awake.
Oof. Wow. Well, first of all, I shouldn't be shocked because this is NF. So NF is talking about some serious stuff here. I'm getting the sense of a person who is having all that they think they need in life, but they are still, in a sense, they are still asleep, right? They need to wake up to understand the true purpose of life, in a sense. What is the ultimate purpose of life? Is it all the stuff that we've owned, have achieved? Or is there more to life than these things? And he says, the problem and the reason you could never fill a hole in your life is because you were never awake. Huh. I can preach all day. Let's get back to the song.
The reason you can never fill a hole in your life is because you were never awake.
You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape. Because you live your life in a coma.
Wake up.
you feeling like you ain't got a purpose. And you're trying to get motivated, but everything you do turns into a mess, like you ain't nothing but worthless. And yo, you look around, a lot of these other people you looking at, to you, you describe as perfect. So you point a finger at God and tell him to do his job and fix your life up, cause nothing is working. And you would try to hide it and make it seem like it's nothing, but really you feel like everything is crashing around you. And you developed a problem in trusting in other people, which later became an issue that would mentally pound you.
Lord have mercy. First of all, yo, this journey that I'm having with NF, I must admit, it's only getting better. Maybe I'm the one who's late to, you know, I'm late for the party. Okay, I get it. I need to do some catch up. So, but it's like every song that I'm checking out with this brother, every song I look at from this artist, this man is only putting out content that are so real. I can understand why Real happens to be one of those. Is that the clothing line that he has? But duh. You hear what he's talking about? It's like, yo, this is like, it's crazy. I've been talking about exactly these things. And we can look at Hollywood and all the things that's going on there and all the stuff we have. All the stuff they've gone, they owned. Stuff. It's just not enough.
Only get one life, but every time you're looking at yours,
we gotta make it up.
Like it's nothing, but really you feel like everything is crashing around you. And you developed a problem in trusting in other people, which later became an issue that would mentally pound you. You only get one life, but every time you're looking at yours, you feel like all you ever see are mistakes. And the problem and the reason you can never move forward in life is because you were never awake. Wake up.
You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape.
Yeah.
Cause you live your life in a coma, you're never awake.
That is crazy. Yeah. How about that? This is amazing. This is amazing stuff. Yo, what do you do with that? NF has a song called Wake Up, where he talks about all the stuff you have in life, and they are just not good enough. You know, the thing about the human spirit and the way that you were created by the hand of the creator, stuff could never be enough to fulfill the heart of men. NF gets it. That's why you can look at a lot of people who have money. And nothing's wrong with having money, by the way. It's a great thing. It's a great blessing. Money is a defense, the Bible says. So the issue is not the money, particularly, is where our treasure is. That's the issue. Does money own my heart? Is my heart owned by God? That's really the big question here. What you have, is good to have the things you have. But are you being owned by the things you have? Do the things you have now have you? And that's the question we got to answer here. So that's why you see people with a lot of money, big mansion and so on, suicidal. They're miserable. They're unhappy. Why? Because
There's more to life than these things. Especially if you haven't found yourself. I listened to Elon Musk in some of his videos where he was talking about what is the meaning of life. We're talking about the richest, one of the richest men on earth, most respectable for all his achievements. This man is way above, way ahead of his time, achieving so much. But Elon Musk is wrestling with one major question right now. What is the meaning of life? Is it all about this stuff? I have it all, but I'm feeling like something is still missing. I have it all. I've done it all. I've achieved all the things that I could possibly achieve. I've gone to school, got the college, got the money, got the wealth, got the people, got the knowledge. And then what? And then what? Something else is still missing. Well, I can tell you what it is. First of all, let me say something. Let's go to the Bible, right? Come with me. Let's go to Ecclesiastes, right? You want to understand the true meaning of life? Read the book of Ecclesiastes. There goes a man who've done it all, okay? Who've achieved it all. There goes the richest man ever lived. When it's all said and done, when it comes to him, listen to what he had to say. And listen, ain't nobody has ever been made so much money as Solomon has, okay? And I say richest man. Nobody's ever tapped that or could ever tap that amount of wealth Solomon had. All right? Listen. He said this. He made everything beautiful in his time. He have set the world in their hearts, and that no man can find out the work of God, make it from the beginning to the end. You gotta be careful with the King James. There's so much in here, right? He have set the world in their hearts. You see that right there? That's huge. The word world here, the English translation says world, but it is really the word eternal life. It is really the word which means there is no ending to the cycle. So it's not talking so much about the world in the sense of what we define it as, but it's saying I have put eternity in their hearts. So get that. This is why men can never be happy, because there is a God-shaped hole in his heart. Eternity is in our hearts. In essence, we were created for something deeper and something broader, something bigger than what we usually aim for. So when we aim too low, there is a sense of dissatisfaction and emptiness and void. And we feel that something isn't right. Why? Because in your heart, God has put a God-shaped hole that can only be fulfilled with his presence. Eternity. You see, this is why Jesus came to give what? Eternal life. Because he knows that's the greatest thing that man needs. We were created to live with God forever. That's been missing in the equation. So the true meaning of life, in essence, is to find God and to live in accordance with his law and to love our fellow men and to live eternally with him. So there's much more to life than what we are told and what we know. You know, Solomon, when you read the whole entire Ecclesiastes itself, you'll find out Solomon says, I've everything. I've acquired all the wealth. I have all the money in the world, and I did this, and I did that. I built this, and I married this, and I tried this, and I bought.
And you know what he said at the end of the day? He said, all this stuff is vanity. Vanity, vanity, all is vanity. I've got it all, but all is vanity. Now, when you go to the Ecclesiastes chapter 12, this is the last few verses of the entire book, right? How do you think he closes the book? The man talks about everything that he's done, all these achievements, and he came to the conclusion, everything is vanity. Wealth, money, this, that, cars, this and this, duh. So what? When it's time to die, you're not taking anything with you. It's all going to be left right here. The only thing you're going to take with you is your faith, your belief in God. If you don't have it, that's trouble. That's big trouble. Now, watch this. It says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments. For this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment to every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. There you have it. So according to Ecclesiastes, God has... He's reminding us that there is a judgment. And he says, the purpose of life is to fear God, is to keep his law. That's it. Fear God and live according to his will. Fear God and keep the Ten Commandments of God. Fear God, which means trust and faith in Jesus Christ. That's where the fear of God comes. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil. So when you have the fear of God in your heart, that means you have a relationship with Jesus Christ and you reverence God. That's what happens here. It's not afraid, I'm afraid of God. No, it's truly reverence. It's truly submission. It's truly respect for God because of who he is and what he's done. So therefore, once you fear God, you will then keep his commandments. For this is the whole duty of man. In other words, this is the meaning of life for every man. You can say that. So God is going to judge every man. Keep that in mind as well. Let me give you one final verse and we're done. Hang with me here. Let's go to Ephesians chapter 5. This is a good one. And I love what NF says. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up from what? Spiritual death. Wake up from what? Spiritual stupor. Wake up from what? Out of the darkness. Step into the light. Wake up from what? Wake up. Realize that you are a sinner and you are in need of a savior. Wake up. Wake up. Why? There's more to life than just making money. Wake up. From what? Wake up because you're still sleeping. You don't get it. You were created for something bigger. Wake up. You were created for something better. Wake up. Stop lying to yourself. Stop trusting in what the devil is telling you. You're not good enough. You're a piece of crap. Maybe partially true. But God wants to do for you much more than these things you've already done for yourself, right? Let's go now to Ecclesiastes, to Ephesians chapter 5. Wherefore he saith, awake, that thou sleepest, arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. Awake, wake up, stop sleeping. Arise from the spiritual death that you're in. Realize that you have an accountability to God. You have a God who loves you and cares for you, who wants to do much more for you than all of the stuff that you talk about, right? And he tells you that, see that you walk circumspectly, not as fool, but as wise, redeeming the time. Stop wasting time. Because the days of evil, wherefore be not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. Get to know the will of God for your life. Stop wasting time. Don't be foolish, be wise. We are living in evil days. Aren't you paying attention? Don't you watch the news? Even the fake news? Some of them. But when you move on, it tells you that you need to wake up. Arise from the dead, and Christ will give you the light. Thank you, Edda, for this one. My heart is blessed. I can go on and on. I'm just blown away by the content of this artist. What do you think about this reaction video? Are you awake? Have you been awakened? Have you paid attention? Much more. Have you made Jesus Christ Lord and Savior of your life? Do you need help to do that? Get in touch with me. We might be able to spend some time together studying the Bible. If that's something you want, personal Bible study with me, I will set up the time. We can have a schedule put together where we spend time studying the Word of God together. Separate from YouTube. One-on-one virtual Bible study for those of you who are hungry for the Lord. I will dedicate the time to do it to you, one-on-one, to do it with you. Thank you so much for listening. Once again, God bless you. Thank you for checking this one out with me once again. Until next time, and as always, remember to look unto Jesus and to live by faith. Have a good one. Bye.